Welcome to another episode of Brics Garden Book Series. Today's episode that we want to understand more about containers in urban foodscapes. In the previous few episodes, we have learnt about seeds, seedlings, the growing medium for having a terrace garden or the organic terrace garden, mostly into growing vegetables and medicinal plants, fruit plants and other things. Today's episode to understand better that we are on the terrace of Ms. Pratima Adiga, who is one of the successful terrace gardeners of Bengaluru, who is growing different type of vegetables in different kinds of containers. To start with, basically urban gardening, urban foodscape has become almost container gardening today. So we are growing food crops in terrace gardens, we are growing in balconies, and we may be growing in ground space, maybe in the front yard or in the backyard, but it is almost tiled nowadays in all houses. So we have to use containers, we cannot grow directly in the ground. So for this purpose, so we have to use different type of containers depending upon the crops requirement. The crops like leafy greens, like coriander, palak, methi and other things, where you need only 6 inches of depth. So there the container has to be shallow, not very deep. So 6 inches of container is more than sufficient. For some crops like chilli, tomato, brinjal, we call them as bush types, and they don't grow too tall, maybe 2 feet, 3 feet in terrace garden situations. For them, what you need is at least 12 inches of containers, maybe or 1 cubic feet, 1 feet, 1 feet, 1 feet. And for the vine vegetables or the creeper types, climber types, by nature they are long durated. They will be there for 150 to 180 days in the containers. So for them, what we need is at least 1.5 feet type of containers, 1.5, 1.5, 1.5, or in cubic feet, about 4.5 cubic feet containers are required for the vine type of vegetables, and you have to create climbers for them to grow better. And the other types that what we are generally suggesting in container gardening is the fruit crops or the perennial plants like curry leaf, lemon, sapota, guava, pomegranate, or even banana, papaya. All these kind of crops can be grown without any problems in containers. Only issue is that they have to be little heavy at the base. So you have to have at least 2 feet containers, 2 by 2 by 2, or more taller. Maybe for banana you may have to have 4 feet containers, for papaya you may have to have 4 feet containers, because banana and papaya you cannot prune them so that you can grow them as bushy plants. For example, sapota, guava and other things, if they are growing too tall, that you can prune them, and they can be grown as a bushy plant. In case of papaya, banana, it is not possible, you have to have taller containers. So that way, depending upon the type of crop, depending upon the duration of the crop, depending upon the depth of the crops or the roots, so you have to select out containers for urban foodscapes. So if you want to start a terrace garden or a balcony garden tomorrow, not necessarily that you have to go to an horticulture shop. So we have so many containers in our household, maybe a broken bucket, a can, a metal can, or in a plastic can. So you can make them with few drain holes and start using them as containers, at least just to understand whether the conditions in your garden, in your balcony, is good for growing vegetable plants or flower plant or whatever type of plant you want to grow. So otherwise, just imagine that you have a paint bucket, you can use them. If you have a gunny bag, if you have a cement bag, so you can use them. A milk packet can be used for growing crops like pudina. So depending upon the type of crop that you are growing, you can use so many containers in your household. Otherwise, if you get into a horticulture shop, you will have mud pots, you will have plastic pots or the fiber pots, you can get cement pots, you can get the coir pots like this. So made out of coconut coir, which is natural origin, highly biodegradable, very good root aeration. So plants grow better in this kind of situation. You will have jute bags today like this. The jute bags are made again natural origin and very good root aeration. So like that, smaller ones and bigger ones. Or if you want, so you will have UV stabilized grow bags like this. See, in Bengaluru you will get from My Dream Garden. So this kind of maybe 15 inches grow bags or 18 inches grow bags or even quite big, the 36 inches grow bags, which can be used for growing a different type of perennial plants. This kind of high density grow bags available. See, this kind of containers or the grow bag is sufficient for crops like chili, tomato, brinjal. So this is good for crops like wine vegetables like bitter gourd, ridge gourd and other things. So that way, see, you can select out based on your requirement. These kind of grow bags have come. These are called breathable grow bags. So there is some aeration. They are not simply plastic materials. So you can use this kind of grow bags of different sizes. People have made smaller ones, bigger ones and other things. So depending upon your requirement, you can use the grow bags. For crops like tomato, which is a bush type of plant, maybe, or chili, brinjal and other things, what you need is 12 inches container. So you can select out the type of container that you want, whether you want a mud pot, whether you want a plastic pot, whether you want a grow bag, whether you want a jute bag, whether you want a coir pot. That is the choice of the owner. So the way that he wants to put his crops in a healthier condition, so that way that you can select out the containers. So traditionally, we have used mud pots. See, this may be 12 inches or sometimes 15 inches, 18 inches for crops like chili or crops like brinjal, crops like tomato, or strawberry that you can just make out. These are all can be grown in the containers of 12 inches or 18 inches, depending upon the size that you can get. Similarly, you see paint buckets where the crops like say zucchini, so nicely that it has come. The brinjal, the paint buckets can be used. It is about 15 to 18 inches of size, and you can use them for growing these kind of crops. See here, paint buckets are cut into two pieces, and you can use them for growing different type of leafy vegetables. See, it is sesame, the coriander is there, and maybe leafy vegetables like amaranth, palak. See, all these kind of crops can be grown in the water drums cut into two pieces. See the grow bags. So whether it is cabbage, whether it is colocasia, whether it is your exotic vegetables, lemongrass, tomato, chili and other things. So depending upon the type of crop that you are growing, that you can use grow bags. So if you don't want to put directly on the floor, that you can keep them on stands. See, the wine vegetables like ridge gourd, bitter gourd and other things, at least in this case, zucchini. So which is grown in this 20 liters paint buckets, and this comes up so nicely, and this is a luxury for crops like zucchini or bitter gourd, ridge gourd and other things, and they grow so nicely in this kind of container and enjoy them the growing conditions. The perennial plants like hibiscus, flowering plants. See, we are not that against ornamentals or flowering plants when it comes to urban gardening. We have to use the flowering plants as well for our puja and other purposes. So all these hibiscus, this is this parijata plant. So all these can be grown in this kind of 20 liters containers. See, this kind of fiber drums for growing lemon or even oranges, even up to sapota, guava and other things. This kind of 2 feet containers can be used at least for first 4 or 5 years of plant growth. See this container on Pratima Adiga's terrace. So they have made a kind of container with tiles which is about 1.5 feet depth, directly on the terrace. There is no the plastic buckets or something like that. They have taken excess or extra care to make the waterproofing and other things so that there is no problem of leakage and other things. So better waterproofing and all these things are done, and the growing medium is directly put in the pit or on the terrace. And here different type of crops can be grown. It is almost like natural condition growing crops in the field. So only thing is it is contained in the sites with the tiles and bricks. See, grow bags are so practical for whether it is brinjal, even for crops like radish, that you can use different type of paint buckets, tomato, chili, and all these kind of crops can be grown in 12 to 15 inches grow bags. See, drumstick can be grown in that kind of containers with about 2 feet height. It would have been better if it is about 60, 70, 80 liters of drum. So even then you can see plant growing. It is about 2 years drumstick plant and having fruits. So you can grow very well in this kind of containers. Maybe curry leaf, just imagine curry leaf. Curry leaf also can be grown in this kind of container at least for first 2-3 years of plant growth. See here the bush pepper variety on the terrace in the containers. So this kind of wide mouth drums, maybe about 40 liters capacity tubs. So that can be used for growing the bush pepper variety, and it grows so nicely in this kind of containers. So see this type of container. These are our vegetable tubs or the milk crates. So this kind of tubs can be used for growing. See, crops like papaya can be grown in this kind of tubs for some time. Like that, see, variety of containers can be used for growing variety of crops. So container is not an issue. What goes inside the container is the issue. So here you can make out different type of containers for growing different type of crops. Today's episode that we have learnt about the different type of containers for urban foodscapes. We have learnt that container is not the issue. We have to use good quality growing medium to grow different type of crops. Variety of containers that we have seen. So you can use broken household materials like buckets or cans or something like that, or you can use the bags, whatever you have. Milk packets can be used as a container, or the paint buckets, or the mud pots, or the plastic pots, or the fiber drums, or the cement pots. See, all these kind of containers can be used to grow different type of crops. So anyway, we will be dealing with all these kind of things as we move on. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. LP for more updates, and keep watching the episodes to come. Thank you.